In the beginning, there were children, and for a time, it was pretty cool. The kids played on the beaches, explored the wild forests, and relaxed in the fields. The world was their big, endless playground. They built themselves simple tree houses, and they lived without rules or nap times. But it was not long before they became bored, as children do. Soon, their perfect society gave way to laziness. Thus did children decide to create adults in their own image, only fatter, funnier looking, and bigger, so they could reach cereal boxes on high shelves. The children dressed the adults in stupid outfits so they could laugh at them, and gave them goofy names like Mr. Ploppington. The adults, loyal and eager to please, worked tirelessly to do the children's bidding, making them peanut butter and jelly sandwiches, cleaning up all of their messes, and building larger and more elaborate treehouses for children to play in. And yet, the adults got no respect from children, these strange, short-legged creatures with snot running down their noses. With the adults already overworked and given no time to themselves, the children demanded that they construct the coolest monument yet, a grand treehouse, one larger than all the treehouses before it, that all of Kiddom could live in and play in. And they called it the Super Double Mega Triple Treehouse. The adults worked endlessly around the clock to keep this seemingly impossible vision while still keeping up with their cooking, lawn mowing, and attending to their children's whims, like playing horsey. It was not long before seeds of dissent took root. Mr. Wigglestein, a name that will never be forgotten. He was the first of his kind to rise up against children in what would come to be known as the really bad thing that happened. At Mr. Wigglestein's trial, the prosecution argued for a child's right to play horsey whenever and as much as he or she wanted. But Mr. Wigglestein testified that he had had a rough day at work and just didn't feel like playing horsey. Pressed to the point of madness by his child's constant whining, Mr. Wigglestein finally snapped. In a blind rage, he grabbed the child and rapidly paddled his bottom with his hand. This new, rather stingy act was from then on called spanking, and forever changed the relationship between kids and adults. The furious leaders of children quickly ordered the immediate exile of Mr. Wigglestein and every one of his kind from every treehouse on the planet. Banished from childland, the adults set off to find their own promised land. A place without treehouses, where children wouldn't always complain and jump up and down on the bed. A place they could call home. They christened this new place Cleveland, and in time, it prospered. The adults built suburban houses, went to lecture series, and ate liverwurst sandwiches. Eventually, their industries bred products that not even childhood could resist. And they called them toys. But the adults' demand for money made it difficult for children to obtain these toys without having to stoop to tasks like delivering newspapers and mowing lawns for the adults. The children were outraged. Why should they be forced to pay for the adults' creations when the adults were creations of their own? Many among them wished to simply take the toys, but knew they could not do so long as adults held the painful threat of spanking over them. So the children devised a desperate act, one that kids would attempt again in the future, with similarly disastrous results. The destruction of coffee, the adults' energy source. Without it, the children could march right into Cleveland and take the toys from the cranky and powerless adults. The prolonged bombing of Cleveland's coffee shops lasted for weeks. But unlike the children's delicately and shoddily crafted treehouses, the adult coffee shops had nothing to fear from water balloons.
Fellow adults, the age of children is over.
Outraged at the children's unwarranted attack, the adults decided the children needed what they called the big time out. Troops advance outward in every direction, and one by one, the treehouses of children fell. It was not long before childhood's greatest monument, the very symbol of their greed, came under attack, and the children ran away.
They're running! Victory!
That hurt them more than it hurt me!
With the fall of the super double mega triple treehouse, the children fell back to the only remaining place where they could escape the powerful adults. The moon. Satisfied with their victory over the Earth, the adults allowed the children to live on the moon, where they could make all the noise they wanted, and stay up all night eating candy and watching cartoons. And for a time, it wasn't so bad. But it was not long before children began to yearn for the oceans they once swam in, the forests they once explored, and the toys they once played with on Earth. It was at this very same time that adults fell victim to the same sins of laziness and greed that had befallen the children before them. They missed having kids doing chores for them, taking out their trash, and shoveling snow from their driveways. So the adult ambassadors came to the moon base with plans for a civil, stable relationship with children, one where they could all live on the Earth in harmony and equality. The children decided to willingly return to the Earth, and live together with adults in small groupings called families. Children and adults could finally live together as equals. Or could they? Soon afterwards, the adults created places to imprison children called schools, where they drained out all of our memories so that we'd forget we created them. And if that wasn't bad enough, they invented homework and after-school activities to control us even more. And do you hear that coming from the fluorescent lights above your heads? That's the adult microwave cranial jellifier slowly turning our brains into milkshakes. And then they make you brush your teeth because if your teeth rot out, then they can't implant the submolar tracking devices they use to tell where you go when you escape. It's a lie. Everything you know is a lie.
Mr.
They're crushing
Uno.
You beneath their heels, and you can't
Mr.
even see
Uno,
it.
That's
rise
enough.
Up. Rise up and throw off the oppression!
That's enough!
But I was just getting to the good part!
Mr. Uno, that report has absolutely nothing to do with the signing of the Declaration of Independence.
Doesn't it, Mr. Fry Bingle?
I like the part with the giant robot war.
Well, I like when my students actually use their textbooks to write a report and not their ridiculous imaginations. So I'm giving you a double F-.
Aw, he's crazy, Number One. How could he not like the part with the water balloons when the giant treehouse was so...
they